The Torah Garden, speaking the absolute truth. Torah Nation.
Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, Yasharal and Yahuda. Grafted in Gentile to the body of the Mashiach. We be with the broadcast. It's going down. Listen to none other than Hezekiah. Songs entitled Flood Came. I don't want to write to this music. Listen. I have another word, another Besorah, another Torah. But not for me. We gonna hear my Aki Ezra Yahugaol. Yeah. On this Shabbat, he gonna bring the word of truth. Listen, that word was a good word. It was a Torah. It was a Besorah. And I praise you for this Ak, man. This young Ak, man, is a champion. I love this Ak. You will deliver them from Islam. And he's going forth in the power of Yahuwah. And I'm praising Yahuwah for him. So, I want you to give attention and ears to this Aki Ezra. As he brings the word, and the next voice that you're going to hear is going to be his. Hallelujah. Give ear and attention to the word of Yahuwah from this ox. With that, I say shalom, shalom, shalom. The word is to those that have an ear to hear what the Ruach is saying. Hallelujah.
We're going to go ahead. Open up this Shabbat lesson, and we're going to do it with prayer. And I am going to request Yaakov to open us up in prayer. And after that, I'm going to ask Zerah to sing a song or two. Or three. That's the plan. Hallelujah. We're going to do this. So yeah. We bless Yahuwah on this Shabbat. We praise Yahuwah for the opportunity to be able to hear a word, to share a word by the Ruach HaKodesh. And we bless the name of Yahuwah. So let's go forth in this witness and trust the Most High, and believe Yahuwah for a word on this Shabbat. Hallelujah.
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 Abba Yahuwah, we praise you and thank you for awakening up this morning. We praise you for allowing us to see this day, for this is the day that you have made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Abba, we praise you for this Shabbat, this time of rest, this time of pause. It's time to connect and to sit in alignment with your rest.
Yes.
We praise you for this experience that the world moves around us, Abba, to just allow us to sit still and know that you are Yahuwah, our Elul.
Yes.
Abba, I praise you for bringing us through this week.
Yes.
I praise you for the trial. I praise you for the victory. I praise you for every lesson learned and failure, for every opportunity you've given us to repent.
Yeah.
I praise you and thank you, Abba, for allowing, teaching us to discern between thoughts, knowing according to your word what is of you and what is not of you. I praise you for the power to cast down all imagination that exalts itself above the knowledge of who you are.
In the name of Yahusha.
Abba, I praise you for the word is about to come forth. I praise you for this Mishpacha. I praise you for awakening and quickening the children. Jew and Gentile alike.
Yeah,
I praise you for your Torah. I praise you for atonement in Ahasuerus HaMashiach. I praise you for your work, HaKodesh. We are grateful that you have chosen us, Father. We have done this for your namesake. We rejoice in you and we praise you. We come before you, seeking to hear a word, seeking to receive exhortation, correction, and edification onto the perfection of our souls. We praise you and we thank you in the name of Yeshua Mashiach. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Zariah, you ready?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. All systems go.
All systems go. So, I just want to let y'all know, I am trying to switch, I'm going to say convert, to Brit Ya. So she does have some good songs. I haven't gotten it down packed just yet.
Okay.
But I'm praying that by next week, it will be downloaded.
Okay.
So we're gonna get to her, but I do have her. And I have another artist that I've been listening to. Well, actually, Eliezer put me on tour. Her name is Brianna, I want to say, I think.
Okay.
But she's real good, too. So, hallelujah. By next week.
All right. Ministry of Music. Make it happen.
Absolutely.
Hallelujah.
All right. Great is your mercy towards me. Your loving kindness towards me. Your tender mercies I see day after day. Forever faithful towards me. You're always providing for me. Great is your mercy towards me. Great is your grace. Great is your mercy towards me. Your loving kindness towards me. Great is your mercy towards me. Great is your grace. You're forever faithful towards me. Your tender mercies I see. You're always providing for me. Great is your grace. Oh, now I'm going to switch it. Yaakov, yeah. You ready?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Yes, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Abba, you're worthy. Abba, you're worthy. Abba, you're worthy. Abba, you're worthy. Abba, we praise
you. Abba, we praise you.
Abba, we praise you. Abba, we praise you. Abba, we praise you. Forever you're grateful.
Hallelujah.
Forever you're grateful.
Hallelujah.
Forever you're grateful. Forever you're grateful. Abba, we love you.
Hallelujah.
Abba, we love you. Abba, we love you. Abba, we love you. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Beautiful. All praise to Yahuwah Elohim. Hallelujah. That was beautiful. That was beautiful. That was beautiful. That was beautiful. Hallelujah, Yahuwah. Hallelujah, Yahuwah. Hallelujah, Yahuwah. We are now in the hands of none other than Ezra Yahoo, God, all give your attention to the man of Yahoo who's bringing the Besorah, the Torah truth. Hallelujah.
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 She almost made me cry.
Hallelujah. I'm telling you, man.
Yeah, man. So I'm going to start like this, right? Yaakov, all right, you got me right, but I'm going to read this first. If any man speaks, let him speak as the oracles of Elohim. If any man minister, let him do it as of the ability of Elohim, which Elohim gives, that Elohim in all things may be glorified through Yahushua HaMashiach, to whom be praise and dominion forever and ever. Amen. All right. So this is my rhythm today, man. I'm gonna lay out Psalm 16, right? It's really been, it hit hard to me, right? And so I've been trying to study it line by line and find scriptures to help me lay out what this means, right? So I got a couple scriptures, more than a couple. I got a few scriptures to go line by line. But as I was reading the scriptures, I see that some of them are not just for one particular line. They lay out a lot more. So I just want y'all to walk with me on this one. So I'm gonna read this first, right? Guard me, O El, for in you do I put my trust. O my soul, you have said unto Yahuwah, you are my Yahuwah. My goodness extends not to you, but to the Kodeshim that are in the earth, and to the excellent in whom is all my delight. Their sorrows shall be multiplied that hasten after another Elohim. Mm-hmm. Their drink offerings of blood will I not offer, nor take up their names unto my lips. Yahuwah is the portion of my inheritance and my cup. You maintain my lot. The lines are fallen unto me in pleasant places. Yeah, I have a goodly heritage. I will bless Yahuwah, who has given me counsel. My mind also instructs me in the night seasons.
I have set Yahuwah always before me, because he is at my right hand. I shall not be moved. Therefore, my heart is glad, and my glory rejoices. My flesh also shall rest in hope. For you will not leave my soul in Sheol, neither will you suffer your holy ones to see corruption. You will show me the path of life, and your presence is fullness of joy. At your right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. Right? So I'm going to start in Deuteronomy, right? I'm going to start in Deuteronomy 6. That's my first demo, right? So let me see something. That's I pulling it up. I'm going to get another scripture so we could be moving, right? So we can move through this. I won't keep y'all on Shabbat on this lesson too long. All right. So I'm going to read Deuteronomy 6, 23 to 25, right? And he brought us out from thence that he might bring us in to give us in the land which he swore unto our fathers. And Yahuwah commanded us to do all these statutes, to fear Yahuwah Elohim for our good always, that he might preserve us alive, as it is at this day. And it shall be our righteousness if we guard to do all these commandments before Yahuwah Elohim, as he has commanded us. Right. So I'm not going to do too much explaining for these couple verses. I just want to lay them out, right? Mm-hmm. So, all right, you going to Romans? All right, so watch this. This Psalm 16 has did all open up all of this for me, right? So where we at? Romans 11:33, right? Oh, the depth of the riches, both of the wisdom and knowledge of Elohim. How unsearchable are his judgments and his ways past finding out. For who has known the mind of Yahuwah? Or who has been his counselor? Or who has first given to him? And it shall be recompensed unto him again. For of him, and through him, and to him are all things. To whom be glory forever. Amen. Right now I'm in Luke 17. Right? Now Eleazar said something about this yesterday, right? So Luke 17 and 6. And Adonai said, if you have faith, go to Job 35 for me, so I won't have to. I'm gonna read Luke 17. You go to Job for me, Job 35. And Adonai said, if ye have faith as a grain of a mustard seed, ye might say unto a sycamine tree, be plucked up by the root and be planted in the sea, and it should obey you. But which of you, having a servant plowing or feeding cattle, will say unto him by and by, when he is come from the field, go and sit down to meat, and will not rather say unto him, make ready wherewith I may sup, and gird yourself and serve me till I have eaten and drinken, and afterward you will eat and drink? Does he think that servant, because he did the things that were commanded him? I think not. So now I'm at Job, right? Job 35, 7. Go up a little bit. If you be righteous, what give you him? Or what receives he of your hand? Your wickedness may hurt a man as you are, and your righteousness may profit the son of Adam. By reason of the multitude of oppressions, they make the oppressed to cry. They cry out by reason of the arm of the mighty. But none says, Eloah, my maker, who gives songs in the night. Who gives songs in the night, who teaches us more than beasts of the earth and makes us wiser than the fowls of the heavens. So right now, this is, it's like, oh, this is a lot of reading, right? But I'm only, when you look at Psalms, I'm only in the second verse, right? I'm only in Psalm 16, too.
Uh-huh.
And I'm trying to find it again. I told you the stuff would be doing me different. So I'm only in Psalm 16, too, right? And to me, it's, okay, again, guard me, O El, for in you do I put my trust. O my soul, have you said unto Yahuwah, you are my Adonai, my goodness extends not to you, but to the Kodeshim that are in the earth, and to the excellent in whom is my delight. So when I read Luke, right, it's like we have to have faith. Faith is, so David, right? So let me say this first. David, we know who King David was. He was a man after the Most High's own heart. He had faith and he did what was understood of him. Well, he knew after he messed up that his repentance was necessary, and the Most High blessed him in a manner that we may or may not understand, but we have to read scripture to understand the manner in which the Most High blessed him. We know he laid down a demonstration that gave Solomon a reign of peace, because his demonstration was in the Most High. See, I had a conversation with somebody and we was talking about inheritance, and I'm gonna keep going. We was talking about inheritance, and they asked me, is the inheritance tangible or untangible? When you look at what David is laying out, the inheritance is an untangible inheritance. We are looking for the Most High to be everything for us, in us, to us, by us. The Most High is the end all be all, right? Mm-hmm. And I'm going to this by looking at when it says, my goodness extendeth not, right? Extendeth. Mm-hmm. To give or impart, right? To stretch out in any direction, to carry forward or to continue and length as a time, as a line rather. It can also mean to spread in breadth, to expand or to dilate in size. So it might sound like I'm all over the place, but what I'm looking at is what I understand from this, right? And I'm trying to give that to y'all. I'm trying to, the understanding of this scripture is the Most High has to, we have to start with him, right? Like he said, and when he brought those brothers out, when he brought the children of Yasharel out of Mitzrayim, I'm giving you a commandment so you can have a guard, that you can have something to understand what I want, how I want it, and what I need from you, so you can get everything that I laid up for you. Because I told your fathers and your forefathers that I got a demonstration for you. I'm going to make you a great nation, but you got to do this. You got to obey my statutes and stand on my commandments. Obey my commandments and stand on my statutes, right?
Hallelujah.
So all right, I'm going to go down to verse 3, right? So go to Deuteronomy 33, 2 and 4 for me.
Wait, give me that Deuteronomy again. Deuteronomy what?
Deuteronomy 33. So verse 2, verse 3 is, but to the Kodeshim that are in the earth, and to the excellent in whom is my delight.
Okay. That's 33 and what?
That's 33, 3, 2 and 4, I mean. 2 to 4. Go down a little bit. I'll go to 2 for me. Okay. And he said, Yahuwah came from Sinai and rose up from, help me out.
Seer.
Unto them, he shined from Mount Paran, and he came with 10,000s of Kodeshim. From his right hand went a fiery law for them. Yeah, he loved the people. All his Kodeshim are in your hand, and they sat down at your feet. Everyone shall receive of your words. Moshe commanded us a Torah, even the inheritance of the assembly of Yaakov. Go to Daniel 7:18. Yeah, I'm about to lay out the Kodeshim and what that looked like, right? What I'm getting from the Kodeshim in this scripture, right? Let me see something. Who the Kodeshim are? Righteous people. All right. So, Daniel 7:18. But the Kodeshim of Elyon shall take the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever, even forever and ever. Then I will know the truth of the fourth beast. That's going into something else. I'll get to that later, right? So go to Daniel, stay in Daniel, and go to 21. Go to 7:21 for me. Just go up a little bit. I beheld, and the same horn made war with the Kodeshim and prevailed against them until the ancient days came and judgment was given to the Kodeshim of Elyon. And the time came that the Kodeshim possessed the kingdom. Go to 25 in the same 7. And he shall speak great words against Elyon and shall wear out the Kodeshim of Elyon and think to change times and laws, and they shall be given into his hand until a period of time. And the dividing of time. But judgment shall sit, and they shall take away his dominion to consume and destroy it unto the end. Let me see. And 27. And the kingdom and dominion and the greatness of the kingdom under the whole heaven shall be given to the people of the Kodeshim of El Elyon, whose kingdom is an everlasting kingdom. Excuse me. And all dominions shall serve and obey him.
Hallelujah.
Right? Go to Zechariah 14 and 5. Okay, let me see. And he shall flee, and ye shall flee to the valley of the mountains, for the valley of the mountains shall reach unto Estel. Yeah, ye shall flee, like as you fled from before the earthquake in the days of Uzziah, king of Yehuda, and Yahuwah Eloha shall come, and all the Kodeshim with him. So I'm in Matthew 25, 50 and 52, right? Okay. And Yahushua said unto him, Friend, wherefore are you come? Then came they and lay hands on Yahushua and took him. And behold, one of them which
wherewith Yahushua stretched out his hand and drew his sword and struck a servant of the high priest and smote his. Am I in the right?
Yeah, where you at?
Oh, 27. I was reading the wrong scripture. I'm tripping. Okay.
Matthew 25 and 27?
Matthew 27, 52. Yeah, I was reading the wrong scripture.
Okay.
Right. Okay. Yahushua, when he had cried again with a loud voice, yielding up his ruach, and behold, the veil of the temple was rent in two from the top of the bottom, and the earth did quake, and the rocks rent, and the graves were open, and many bodies of the Kodeshim which slept arose and came out of the graves after the resurrection and went into the holy city and appeared unto many. Right? So, like I said, I'm just laying this all out through scriptures, right? Because what do you say, Yaakov? You got to
line upon line.
Not line upon line, but having two and three
witnesses
to show something, right? So I could have stayed at Psalms, right, and laid all this out through all the Psalms of Daud, but that's just one person, right? So I'm showing how what Daud said and what he's saying in Psalm 16 is all through Scripture, right?
God.
This is not just an understanding that David had. This is an understanding that every individual in these scriptures who was talking about the Most High has laid up. But the Kodeshim that are in the earth and the excellent in whom is all my delight. So now, you know, I like to go to Psalm 37 when they talk about delight. You don't got to go there, but Psalms 37 and 4, when it talks about delight yourself in the Most High, and He will give you the desires of your heart. See?
Mm-hmm. Commit your way.
You dig what I'm saying? So So now go back. That's why I didn't want you to go there. Go back to 16 for me. But I'm just saying, because it's whom is all my delight? In whom is all my delight? Right? We have to remember, I set it off to say, Yahuwah is our beginning and our end. He is our starting point. He should be our starting point in everything we do, right? So now let's lean on this part right here. Their sorrows shall be multiplied that hasten after another Elohim. Their drink offerings of blood will I not offer, nor take up their names into my lips. All right, so go here for me. Go to Exodus 3. I'm going to lay out what a drink offering is. Right, because I gotta show this right here. Go. I'm trying to scroll up. Go up a little bit. All right, right there. Go to 20. Exodus 20. So just for clarity purposes of what is a drink offering? You know, I don't want nobody looking at it like I don't know what a drink offering is, because I didn't know what a drink offering was, right? So what is a drink offering? Okay, this is where it's going first. Then I'm going to get into the drink offering. So Deuteronomy 7. All right. Deuteronomy 7 and 4. Okay, so I'm going to come back to the drink offering. I'm going to start with the other L's. You shall have no other L before me. That's a commandment. These are the
That's the third of the Ten Commandments. You shall have no other L before me. Right? Now I'm gonna go to Deuteronomy 7:4-6. For they will turn away your sons from following me, that they may serve other Elohims. So will the anger of Yahuwah be kindled against you and destroy you suddenly. But thus shall ye deal with them. Ye shall destroy their altars and break down their images and cut down their Asherah poles and burn their graven images with fire. For you are a holy people. You are a holy people unto Yahuwah Eloheka. Mm-hmm. Yahuwah Eloheka has chosen you to be a special people unto himself above all people that are upon the face of the earth. Right? So, okay, go to Chronicles, 2 Chronicles 34:25. Right, we're a special people, man. We ain't other gods. The Most High, he said it, laid it out first, right? He said, do not serve other gods. That's a commandment. He ain't say, if you feel like it, if you want to, just don't do it. Why? If you do it, I'm going to destroy everything you got going on. You ain't going to have nothing because you're putting something else before me, right? So, you at 2 Chronicles 34:25. Because they have forsaken me and have burnt incense unto other Elohims, that they might provoke me to anger with all the works of their hands. Therefore, my wrath shall be poured out upon this place and shall not be quenched. That's a serious demonstration right there. Serving other elves, he said that that they might provoke me with all the works of their hand. Therefore, my anger shall be poured out upon this place and shall not be quenched. As long as you serve other gods and doing other things before the Most High, you are going to have his wrath poured out upon you. And it shall not be put out until you stop doing what you're doing. So you could look at, oh, why is this going like this? Why is this going wrong in my life? Now, let's not get it twisted. He put us through trials and tribulations, right? He does things because we ask for things, right? So don't think just because you're going through something, you got the wrath of the Most High. Don't get that misconstrued. Because you may ask for strength, and he'll give you a trial to go through, or he'll give you a tough time. You may ask for patience, and he'll give you something to show yourself patience. You may ask to be more of a loving person, and he'll put a person in your life so you can love them. However, when you not putting the Most High first and you are putting other things before him, this is your rhythm right here. Therefore, my wrath shall be poured out upon this place and shall not be quenched. Now,
hey, I'm going to go.
What's some examples of other L's? Okay, let's do it like this. We could go with, it says wood, stone, and what's another one? Okay, so let's say money. Money is another L. Okay. Pride. Yourself can be an L that you put before the Most High.
Yes.
So when we talk about worship, you know, there was a lot of gods in the lands. So, you know, kings that say, worship me, because I'm the god of this land. So worship me, and like Pharaoh, he put himself before the Most High, right?
Hallelujah.
So worship me, excuse me, Daniel, his king, the king, who was around Daniel's time,
Worship me. This is what I'm going to do. I'm going to set this demonstration up. Every time you hear this bell go off, lay down and worship me. He went crazy, lost his mind. Most I had him wandering in the wilderness like 7 years or something like that until he realized, oh, I've been doing wrong. Let me tighten up and worship the God of Daniel and do what I'm supposed to do. And the Most High brought him up out of that. So that's what he said when he said in Deuteronomy, he gonna break your altars, burn your statues, burn your pictures, all your images getting burnt down. Anything that you put, because the Most High say, don't make no graven images of the land, sea, earth, of nothing. So you shouldn't have an image that you saying, I'm going to worship this as my God. That ain't what he told you to do. He told you don't do that. So, you know, we have these pictures, we have these crosses and all this other stuff that we lay up to say, you know, this is my demo. Nah, you putting something before the Most High. So I got one more. Go to Jeremiah 7 and 16.
Beautiful.
Got one more for you, right? Therefore, pray not for this people, neither lift up cry nor pray for them, neither make intercession to me, for I will not hear you. All right, check that out, right? What did he say? Now, don't forget I said I'm going to go to the drink offering. Leave that right there. All right, leave that right there because I'm going to Psalms. I'm going to find it. Don't worry about it. I got it. I got to show this right here. What David say, man? What did he say? He said, check it out. Their sorrows shall be multiplied that hasten after other Elohim. Their drink offerings of blood will I not offer, nor take up their names unto my lips. Why? Because therefore pray not for this people, neither lift up cry nor prayer for them, neither make intercession to me, for I will not hear you. You dig what I'm saying? So David knew what the rhythm was. Y'all want to go after other Elohims? I ain't got nothing for you because everything I got is for the Most High. And all my people understand that. So you got to be under this for me to give you what I got for you. If you're not under this, I don't have no rhythm for you. I don't want to talk to you. I'm just putting that on. I'm putting 100 on 10. That's me right there. Right. But
that's him too.
We have to have an understanding. That's right? Him too. We have. That's you dig what I'm saying? That's him too.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So the drink offering. But, all right. Because I said I was going to lay that up for you. The drink offering. Go to Genesis 35, 12 and 15. I'm going to give you the drink offering. Because I said I was going to do that. What is 35? Okay, 35, 12. And the land which I gave Abraham and Yitzhak, to you will I give it, and to your seed after you will I give the land. And Elohim went up from him in the place where he talked with him, and Yaakov set up an altar in the place where he talked with him, even a pillar of stone, and he poured a drink offering thereon and poured oil thereon. Right now, go to Exodus 29:39. So the drink offering is kind of heavy, right? And I could have Elder, if you and James could explain it a little further, because I don't have a whole laid out explanation. I just have, you know what I'm saying, scripture. I don't really got the total demonstration. Then the one lamp, go to 38 for me. Go down a little bit. Okay.
Now this is that which you shall offer upon the altar, two lambs of the first year, day by day, continually. The one lamb you shall offer in the morning, and the other lamb you shall offer at the evening. And with the one lamb, a tenth deal of flour mingled with fourth part of a hin of beaten oil, and the fourth part of a hin of wine for a drink offering. Go up a little bit more. And the other lamb you shall offer at the evening, and shall do thereto according to the oblation of the morning, and according to the drink offering thereof, for a sweet savor, and an offering made by fire unto Yahuwah. Now, go to 2 Kings 16:15. Right, I'm just laying up what a drink offering is, and that this is a demonstration. Right, this is not just, and so and King Achaz commanded Arayahu the priest, saying, upon the great altar, burn the morning ascending smoke offering, and the evening oblation, and the king's ascending smoke sacrifice, and his oblation, and the ascending smoke offering of all the people of the land, and their oblation, and their drink offerings, and sprinkle upon it the blood of the ascending smoke offering, and all the blood of the sacrifice, and the brazen altar shall be for me to inquire by. Right? So I'm just laying out that this is not just a situation. You see, it started with Yaakov. Yaakov laid out the drink offering, and it's a continual demonstration, right? So remember. Their sorrow shall be multiplied that hasten after another Elohim. Their drink offerings of blood will I not offer, nor take up their names unto my lips. I'm going to go to 5. Yahuwah is my portion of my inheritance and my cup. You maintain my lot. The lines are fallen unto me in pleasant places. Yeah, I have a goodly heritage. Right? So that was 5. And then I'm going to go, I will bless Yahuwah who has given me counsel. My mind also instructs me in the night seasons. Mm-hmm. Okay, right. So go to Numbers 18:20. Check this out. Check me out. Because he said, you are a portion of my inheritance. Who did the Most High lay this up for? Who did the Most High say this to when he first said this? Right? David understands something that's heavy, heavy rhythm, right? So, Numbers 18:20. And Yahuwah spoke to El Haran, you shall have no inheritance in their land, neither shall you have any part among them. I am your part and your inheritance among the children of Yashareth. Mm-hmm. How heavy is that? The Most mm-hmm. High said, I'm your part of your inheritance. And behold, I have given the children of Levi all the tenth and Yashareth for an inheritance for their service which they serve, even the service of the tabernacle of the assembly. Mm-hmm. Now, David said, you are my portion of my inheritance. He understands that everything comes from the Most High Yah. Mm. Everything. So when he break down the inheritance, he gave this tribe this, give this tribe that, right? Broke down the 12 tribes of how we're going to give an inheritance. But Levi, they don't get nothing.
They don't get nothing of this land stuff. They don't get nothing of because I'm their portion. Mm-hmm. Right? That's we look at it tangibly. Like, remember I said I was asked about this intangible. We look at things tangible. Okay, you get a dollar, I get a dollar, but dang, I don't get one? Why I don't get one? Because yours coming from a whole nother place. Yours ain't coming from what we go gather and what we grow, and it ain't coming from that in the sense of you can see it. But everything you need and everything your people will need, you will always have it. Mm-hmm. Because it's not coming from your hands and your works. It's coming from your faith that is the size of a mustard seed, that if you say to a sycamore tree, move and be planted in the water, it'll move and go in that water because you believe that the Most High is everything you need. Mm-hmm. So check this out. Go to my cup, right? Go to Psalms. Go to Psalms 23 and 5. And I ain't gonna lay too much on this. I ain't gonna lay too much on this, right? Because David understood the cup, right? You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runneth over, right? So when I look at this, right? When I look at, we talk about filling our cups and keeping our cups filled with scripture, keeping our cups filled with righteousness, fasting and praying so we can empty the cup, clean it out for real, so we can get the, there's no remnants of what has been hindering me in my cup, because we are given a cup as well. You have to empty your cup out, clean it out thoroughly, and you do that by fasting and praying and understanding this Torah that the Most High has laid out for you. David said his cup run over because he's putting all he can in this cup that the Most High has laid out. All his righteousness, his services, everything he do, he's doing it for the Most High. And the Most High is going to continue to fill his cup with righteousness, continue to fill his cup with understanding, continue to fill his cup with grace, favor. You dig what I'm saying? This is what mm-hmm. we're looking for. We're not just saying, oh, I got a cup and what's in it, I don't know. No, you know what's in your cup because you are putting forth righteousness. You are putting forth this obedience that the Most High has laid out and told you what to do in obedience by observing his commandments, observing his ordinances, standing on his statutes, right? To do this from, go to Matthew 20. Right? Because we get this cup confused because we hear Mashiach say, take this cup from me. Right? People be like, oh, well, he said, take this cup from me. But right, let's do this then. Right. See, we can't confuse this right here. Matthew 20 and 20. Right. Then came to him. The mother of Zebedee's children with her sons worshiping him and desiring a certain thing of him. And he said unto her, what will you? She said unto him, grant that my two sons may sit, the one on the right hand and the one on the left hand in your kingdom. But Yahushua answered and said, ye know not what you ask, what ye ask. Are you able to drink of the cup that I shall drink of and to be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with? They said unto him, we are able. Go up a little bit. Huh? And he said unto them, ye shall drink indeed of my cup and be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with. But to sit on my right hand and on my left is not mine to give, but it shall be given to them for whom it is prepared of my Father. Right? Yeah. So now check this out. Go to Matthew 26, 37.
I just want to, I ain't going to go because I got Mark, Luke. I could go through all of them, but I'm going to just do, I ain't going to do all of them, right? I got, if you want to write it down, it's Mark 14, 33, 38, Luke 22, 37 and 45. 37 to 45. But I'm going to just go right here. Matthew 26 and 37. And he took with him Kepha and the two sons of Zebedee and began to be sorrowful and very heavy. Then he said unto them, my soul is exceeding sorrowful, even unto death. Tarry ye here and watch with me. And he went a little further and fell on his face and prayed, saying, oh, my father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as you will. Right? I think I do want to go to Luke. Go to Luke. Go to Luke 23, 22, 37, and 45. This one is a little different, right? This one, I kind of like this one. I kind of like this one.
Wow. Okay. I just think so.
22, 37, and 45. For I say unto you that this is written must yet be accomplished in me. And he has reckoned among the transgressors, for the things concerning me have an end. And they said, Adonai, behold, behold, here are two swords. And he said unto them, it is enough. And he came out and went as he went to the Mount of Olives, and his Talmudim also follow him. Go up a little bit. And when he, no, go down. Okay. And went right there. And when he was at the place, he said to them, pray that ye enter not into temptation. And he was withdrawn from them about a stone's cast and kneeled down and prayed, saying, Father, if it be willing, remove this cup from me. Nevertheless, not my will, but yours be done. And there appeared an angel unto him from heaven, strengthening him. Go up a little bit more. And being in agony, he prayed more earnestly, and his sweat was as it were great drops of blood falling down to the ground. And then he went back to, but look at the strength that came to him, right? This is why I like this one, because the angel appeared, there appeared an angel and strengthened him, mm-hmm. right? We know what this demonstration is, right? I'm not going to get into it, but this was just about the cup that can get misconstrued, because what he said, nevertheless, not my will, but yours be done. And it was so. Right? He is our strength and our redeemer. He is our reckoner, because he went through his sacrifice. He understood it. His sacrifice is the reason why we are able to have this word and get it the way we got it, and have it a stony heart removed from us and a heart of flesh put in us, because we come through HaMashiach, right?
Hallelujah.
So I'm still going. Go to Jeremiah 3:19 for me. I'm about to end this demonstration like this. Not with Jeremiah, but I'm about to end it like this.
Jeremiah
3:19. But I said, how shall I put you among the children and give you a pleasant land, a goodly heritage of the hosts of nations? And he and I said, ye shall call me my father, and shall not turn away from me. Right? So when we look at inheritance and heritage, heritage is something, I looked it up last night. Let me look it up so I won't be wrong when I'm saying it. Right? Heritage is, let's see. Hold on, give me 1 second. I apologize. Okay. So heritage signifies the everlasting bond between the Most High and his people, right? Mm-hmm. Now dig it. An everlasting bond mm-hmm. between the Most High and his people. See, David knew this. This is what David said. I have a goodly heritage, right? Because he understand the bond between him and the Most High. It ain't just, the Most High is the Lord over me and I got to worship him. No, it's more than that. It's the Most High is my everything. Everything starts with him. If I can't be a friend to the Most High, how can I be a friend to you? If I can't love the Most High, how can I say I love you? If I can't say I respect the Most High's word, how can I say I respect your word? You understand what I'm saying? So we have to understand, and I don't mean to say that you don't understand it, but what I'm saying is we have to understand that the Most High, Yah, is everything first. Hallelujah. Everything we understand has to be in him first. Because without that, we just moving. We just moving with nothing. We're not anchored in nothing. It's like grass being able to cut down stuff just blowing in the wind, right? We not like a tree rooted and planted on soundness and unmovable, right? We not like that if we don't got the Most High. We need the Most High to root us in this demonstration, right? So, like I said, I'm going to end this right here like this, though. Go to Hebrews 12 and 2. Because I said that you read Psalm 16, 1 to 11. But when you read other scriptures, it lay it out way different, right? Because like this, 12 and 2. Looking unto Yahushua, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of Elohim. Right? Remember I said that there are scriptures that gonna lay certain things out. Now I'm going in right here. This is not the end, but I'm at 11. You will show me the path of life, and your presence is fullness of joy. At your right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. Right? Now dig this. We just read that. Go to 1 Peter 3 and 22. Who is, okay, let me see. Okay, the like figure whereunto even baptism does also now save us, not that putting away of the filth of the flesh, but the answer of a good conscience towards Elohim, towards Elohim, by the resurrection of Yahushua HaMashiach, who is gone into heaven and is on the right hand of Elohim, angels and authorities and powers being made subject unto him. Now go to Revelations. Go to Revelations 5, 6 for me. Now remember what I said. You will show me the path of life, and your presence is fullness of joy. At your right hand, there are pleasures forevermore, right? And I beheld, and lo, in the midst of the throne and of the living creatures, and in the midst of the elders stood a lamb, as it had been slain, having seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven ruach, right? You got to put the TH on it. Of Elohim sent forth into the earth. And he came and took the sephir out of the right hand of him that sat on the throne. And he had taken the sephir, the four living creatures, and 24 elders fell down before the Lamb, having every one of them kithira, and harps. Golden veil. Huh?
They're like harps.
Yeah, they're like harps. And golden veils full of odors, which are the prayers of the Kodeshim. You dig what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And the song, and they sung a new song, saying, "You are worthy to take the sephir and to open the seals thereof, for you were slain and have redeemed us to Elohim by your blood out of every kindred and tongue and people and nation, and mm-hmm. have made us unto our Elohim kings and priests, and we shall reign on the earth." You dig what I'm saying?
Hallelujah.
You dig what I'm saying? So now remember this right here. You will show me the path of life, and your presence is fullness of joy. At your right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. Hmm. Understand that Yahuwah is our everything. And he is our beginning and our end. And Yahushua HaMashiach is the door which we go to get through that beginning and that end.
Hallelujah.
And I leave y'all with that. That's it.
Hallelujah.
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 Yeah, man. You know what I'm saying? I've been like that demonstration right there, man. Understand it. Like I'm not saying I understand it completely. I'm gonna continue to work on it. But you know, that was a heavy demo for me, man. Like Psalm 16, man. I'm really starting to understand how this word is real, man. Like
Hallelujah.
It's not like we just rapping, man. It's not like we just rapping, man. It was a demonstration laid down for us. It was a demonstration put together for us so we can be a better people and understand the necessities that we have to put forth so we could get somewhere, right? They got the GPS jumping. And, yo, I don't know how to get over here. I go from the GPS and I could get from agent B and do what I need to do. Where your GPS to get to the Most High? How you going to get to the Most High? What you using to get to the Most High?
Hallelujah.
Lay up this scripture, man, and I lay this scripture up, man, for real, man, because at the end of the day, man, my life changed, for real. Like,
Hallelujah.
It ain't just rhythm, right? Like, oh, we want to change. If you put the Most High in your life first, your life going to change, man.
Hallelujah.
Your life going to change. Yeah. So, know what I'm saying? Now I'm done, man. That's it, man. If you got any questions, please relay them to Yaakov, Elder.
Hallelujah. I wanted to briefly hit on the cup, right? Yahuwah required in the morning breakfast and the evening dinner.
Yeah.
In a real sense, right? It was an offering, right? That they made twice a day, right? And this offering was a lamb. This offering was wine or the fruit of the grape, right? And this offering was oil, right? So with the meal and the whole preparation, it's like a preparation thing going on, right? And when Yahusha was in the garden, right, Yahusha had recognized he himself was the offering, right? He was the lamb, right? He was the drink offering to be poured out, right? And in his demonstration, he understood because in the pouring of him out, right, Yahuwah could fill our cups.
Hallelujah.
Right? Because Yahuwah has taking what Yahusha had as a demonstration to a fulfillment of a covenant and a completion of a covenant, now we could be a people who can be filled, right? Because our hearts have been changed. We are a people who can now have this Ruach of Yahuwah to fill us up, right? We can stay full. Our cups can always run over as long as we continue to, as I said, you got to read, you got to fast, you got to pray, you got to do the things that are necessary to keep your cup full, right? And there are going to be things at times that's going to cause your cup to be poured out. But you have to understand that Yahuwah is still going to fill it up as long as you walk in this witness and stay established, grounded, and rooted in him. Right? So, that was... You know, listen, there was a couple of times you almost brought me to tears. And I'm saying to myself, Yahuwah's anointing is real. Yahuwah's anointing is real. Yahuwah's anointing is real. His anointing is real. His demonstration is real, right? To those who choose to receive this witness and to allow Yahuwah to do what he do. And that's what you did, Ak. You allowed Yahuwah to do what he did. And I praise Yahuwah for that. Anybody else?
Yeah, man, that was beautiful. And you, I like that. God the Most High tied it at the end in Revelations because they brought it together to see the untangible become tangible.
Yes.
Right. And it was some things that I didn't realize, just connecting scriptures, like when you read in First Peter, no, it was Second Peter, right?
I think it was First
Peter. It was First Peter, Ezra, First Peter 5:22.
First Peter 3:22.
It was he said the light figure whereunto even baptism does also now save us, not to put in the way of the filth of the flesh, but the answer of a good conscience toward Elohim by the resurrection of Yahushua HaMashiach. And then Hebrews 10 says, and having a high priest over the house of Elohim, but a draw neck, like, nope. Oh, where is it where he says, in the new, in 16, this is the covenant that I will cut with them after those right. days, says Yahuwah, I will put my Torah into their hearts, and in their minds will I write it. So, understanding that the having a good conscience toward the Elohim is the Ruach HaKodesh, is writing the Torah upon your heart and into your mind. And like, this is how you are the Kodeshim. Like, this is how you're the Kodeshim. And how you just spoke of David when he says, my goodness does not extend to you, but to the Kodeshim. You know, it starts he starts with the Most High, but the entire law hinges on two commandments. Yeah. Thou shalt love Yahuwah Elohim all your heart, mind, and strength, and your brother as yourself. And then Peter as James says, how can you say you love Yahuwah but hate your brother? Yahuwah you've never seen, but hate your brother you see every day. But yeah. So David is talking about the tangible of the untangible, the proof that you love the Most High is how you. He's saying that his goodness can't extend to the Most High because his goodness comes from the Most High, but he can show it to the Kodeshim, to those who delight yes. in the will of the Most High. This is how I show it. Like that, you put it together, bro. You put it together. The Most High put it together in you, man.
Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Anybody got any questions? Hallelujah. Well, it's going to be Shabbat Shalom, Shabbat Shalom then. We're going to have Eliezer, will you close us out in prayer?
Absolutely.
Hallelujah. Yeah, we're going to have Eliezer close us out. And we praise Yahuwah for the word of Yahuwah that's come forth empowered and demonstration. You know, I get this to me as expeditiously as you can. And listen, and I encourage everyone to listen to it over and over again.
Yeah,
get it to me too.
We're gonna get her done.
When you put it up, Elder, put the link in the chat again, like you did last time.
Okay, I will.
So that way we know
count on it. It's coming. Hallelujah. Okay. All right, go ahead. Close us out.
Abba Yahuwah, we thank you for giving us another day. We thank you for allowing the Mishpacha to come together in your name, because we know that when two or three are gathered in your name, that you shall be in the midst, Abba. Yes, so Abba, we thank you for coming to our fellowship today and hearing us give praise to you.
Hallelujah.
We thank you for the sacrifices that you've made for us. We ask you to cover us as we go through our next week. We start the next week tomorrow, Abba. We ask you to cover us and keep us until we can all be together again. In the name of Yahusha Mashiach, we pray. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Again.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We was blessed.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Shalom. Shalom. Shalom.
Hey. Now listen real quick. Eliezer is on deck, so he's going to be up for Shabbat next week. So.
All right. Eliyahu,
who wanted
to say something, Elder?
Huh?
Eliyahu
who
in the room about to say something.
Oh, okay.
Shabbat shalom, everybody.
Shabbat shalom.
Hey, Shabbat shalom. Let me say this real quick. Ezra, man, you can definitely see. I can definitely feel and see what the Ruach HaKodesh, what Yahusha HaMashiach has done. You've grown a lot since I've had a chance to really hear your word, his word through you. You've grew a lot. You're powerful. That's a powerful word that you brought right here. I kind of got the portion of it because, you know, I tell you my connection's bad and I've been having a lot of issues with things happening. Well, not issues, but things going on in my life where Yahuwah's been working on me, dealing with me. And I understand. I know I had the Rizpaka to come to and bring and talk to my Rizpaka about the things that Yahuwah has been presenting to me. But I'm going to tell you right now, though, real quick, before we end, that was a powerful word. I mean, I caught a portion of it, but that's a very powerful word. And that's why each day that I'm allowed to, that Yahuwah allowed me to have breath in my lungs and his word to speak unto him and to whoever, or to, not to whoever, but speak unto him, to his chosen people and those who have an ear to hear. That's why I always have to. All through the day, Yahuwah, I pray in the name of Yahusha HaMashiach that everything, every thought, my every word, and my every action and demonstrations be acceptable in your sight, because there are so many people who don't understand really what the scripture is saying. And Ezra, Tommy, you brought it out. You brought that out. You brought that out, and I miss y'all. I really, really, really do. That's why I had a little trouble getting in, but once I finally got in and heard that word, I was like, okay, there you go. I miss y'all. Likewise. Hey, I got a smile on my heart, man. You know? Yeah. This is the Shabbat that I've been waiting for a while, because I told you I've been going through a few things. We all know that when we're doing the right thing, Hasatan comes against us even harder. He's relentless, and he will not give up and try to, he tries everything he possibly can do to keep you discouraged and not wanting to follow, you know, to follow the Ruach HaKodesh and the way Yahuwah is, has presented it to him, to, the Ruach HaKodesh to us. But hey, nevertheless, Yahusha even said in his word that he will, he will never leave us or forsake us, and whoever the, who to whom Yahuwah has put in his hand, he can never take out.
Hallelujah.
So, hey, I just want to give us all esteem and honor to Yahuwah and his word, and for Ezra, for the Mishpacha, and Ezra, hey, I see the growth that has been put within you in order to bring it out of you. And I give all esteem. I'll give esteem to you. Hey, and one more thing, real quick. I still owe y'all one. I haven't forgotten. I know. Hey, and it's been on my Ruach ever since I told Yahuwah, I told you all, my Mishpacha, in the presence of Yahuwah, that I had something I wanted to bring out. That was a testimony, or you know, just a word that Yahuwah has put within me to bring out to the Mishpacha. I haven't forgotten. I owe y'all one.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Huh?
We looking for
it. y'all say y'all ain't letting that go. I understand. Okay, that's all I had to say. You know, and it's good to be in the presence of Yahuwah and my Mishpacha. I appreciate it.
I appreciate you.
Shalom. Hallelujah.
And all minds are clear.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Well, Shabbat Shalom. Yo, Yaakov, stand by. And, you know, everybody, enjoy your rest.
Hold up. Yo, Yaakov, mm-hmm. When is the next time we getting together? Like, what's the next demonstration?
Yeah, we're working that out.
I just
wanted to lay it up there because I don't know what is it. Tabernacles is the next feast days,
but we're trying to figure something out in between now and October.
All right, bet. That's it. That's all I needed.
Hallelujah.
All right.
Shabbat Shalom.
Torah Garden, speaking the absolute truth, Torah Nation.